King Philip's War gave shape to a new country, but at a high cost. The colonial economy was ruined and much of its population was killed, but the war brought them unity and helped the colonists create an American identity. King Philip's War is sometimes called the First Indian War because it was an armed conflict between the Native Americans and the New England colonists. The war started in 1675 and lasted for 3 years. The war itself is named after the Native American leader Metacomet, or known to the English as King Philip. King Philip and the Wampanoag people were known for trading with the colonists for mutually beneficial reasons. In 1618, the Wampanoag population was decreasing because of pandemics of smallpox, spotted fever, typhoid, and measles carried by European fishermen. The natives helped the colonists establish Plymouth Colony in 1620, back when Massasoit, King Philip's father, was the leader of the Wampanoag tribe. The colonists founded Salem, Boston, and other small towns around Massachusetts Bay at a time of increased English migration. However, when the colonists began to encroach on the territories of several Algonquian-speaking tribes in the region, tensions began to flare between Native Americans and colonists, but the relationships remained peaceful for a time. Before King Philip became chief of the Algonquian-speaking Wampanoag tribe, Wamsutta, King Philip's older brother, became chief after the passing of their father Massasoit. In 1662, Wamsutta went to Josiah Winslow's, the governor of Plymouth Colony's, house for some peaceful negotiations regarding the trading of land. When Wamsutta was leaving the town, he suddenly collapsed and died, which was highly suspicious. King Philip, believing that his brother was murdered, began to negotiate with other Algonquian-speaking tribes seeking allies in an eventual fight against the Plymouth colonists in retribution for the death of his brother. John Sassamon, a native translator and advisor to King Philip, told the governor of Plymouth Colony that King Philip was intending to gather allies to attack colonial settlements. King Philip was brought before a court to answer the rumors, and after the court officials admitted to having no proof, they warned him that any other rumors would result in their confiscation of Wampanoag land and guns. Soon after the court hearing, John Sassamon was murdered and his body was found floating in the Assawomset Pond. Three Wampanoag people were tried and executed for the killing of John Sassamon on June 8, 1675. In 1675, on June 20th, a group of Poconoke Indians attacked the Plymouth Colony settlement of Swansea, near modern-day Bristol, Massachusetts. Beginning in June, the Wampanoag, loaded with armor and rifles, attacked colonial settlements and took the lives of over a dozen men, women, and children. English forces counterattacked by destroying native villages and slaughtering most of the inhabitants. On June 28th, 8 days after the assault from the group of Poconoke Indians, officials from Plymouth and Boston responded quickly and sent out a military expedition that destroyed the Wampanoag town in Rhode Island. During the summer of 1675, on July 8th, the war began to quickly spread, and other tribes like the Podunk and Nimpuk tribes began to get involved. Native Americans attacked Middleborough and Dartmouth. While Massachusetts Bay was helping with the aid of Plymouth Colony after the failure of diplomatic solution with King Philip, the Wampanoag people quickly destroyed the town of Dartmouth, which caused the evacuation of Middleborough. During the evacuation, King Philip and the Wampanoag people fled to central Massachusetts, where they continuously attacked, raided, and burned the villages with the gaining of more allies along the way. Chaos and Violence describes the attack in Lancaster on August 9th. Native Americans had arrived at sunrise and started to open fire at the town using the guns they had received in trade with colonists. In early September, the natives attacked Hadley, Deerfield, and Northfield. September 1, 1675. At the height of the war, King Philip used the ruse, "After you're demanding for my land, you're going to pay for the death of Wamsutta," to scare away a large portion of the colonial troops from attacking the Wampanoag to heading north. The natives planned to attack the town of Hadley, Massachusetts, that had close to no protection of colonial troops. However, the settlers discovered the plot and worried with despair of their lives, knowing they were lacking military protection. On September 9th, 1675, the New England Confederation declares war with the natives for the following attacks: Poconoke Attack, Middleborough, Dartmouth, Mendon Settlement Attack, Brookfield Settlement, Lancaster, and the attack on Hadley. September 18th, 1675, was meant to be an uneventful delivery of wheat by ox carts to Hadley, Massachusetts. The men took very little precautions and believed their numbers were large enough that nothing bad would happen to them after the recent attacks that had taken place. King Philip and his Wampanoag people had been heard to cross Connecticut to lie in wait for the delivery to Hadley. Over 60 men were killed and the blood ran into the brook, hence Battle of the Bloody Brook. On November 2nd, 1675, Josiah Winslow led a militia against the Narragansett tribe. The Narragansett weren't entirely involved in the war, but they had been seen sheltering Wampanoag women and children, and several of their men had been reported in Indian raid parties. As the military force tromped around Rhode Island, they burned many abandoned camps made by the Narragansett tribe, which had been left for a massive fort in a swamp. On December 16th, 1675, it was a cold, bitter, storm-filled day, and the massive swamp fort had been found by the military group from Plymouth Colony. The fort occupied 5 acres, and it housed over 1,000 Indians. The fight was fierce, and the fort got burned and was completely destroyed. The inhabitants of the fort, this included women and children, were either killed or evicted, and most of the tribe's winter stores were destroyed. March 12th, 1676, marked a high point for Native American forces when they attacked the Plymouth Plantation. Though the town withheld the assault, the natives showed that they could penetrate deep into colonial territory. 3 more settlements were attacked, with nothing left of the towns. On March 26th, 1676, Captain Pierce, a troop leader who fought alongside and helped Josiah Winslow, led 60 colonists and 20 Christian Wampanoag Indians in pursuit of Narragansett Indians who burned and attacked several towns, including Plymouth, Massachusetts. Pierce's troop caught up with some Narragansett Indians, but they were ambushed. They fought for several hours and began to become outnumbered. 9 of the colonists that were among the group were at first prisoners who got brutally tortured by Narragansett people. They were many of the few who died first in the ambush. Fighting continued into March of 1676 as Nimpucks attacked Groton, Longmeadow, Marlborough, and Simsbury. Then Indians also attacked Rehoboth, and Providence, Rhode Island was destroyed. The Narragansett tribe was defeated and their chief was killed in April, but on May 18, 1676, Captain William Turner, who led a militia group of 200 with Captain Pierce, attacked Peskiopska, and almost none returned home, including Captain William Turner. On June 12th, 1676, a force of 250 Native Americans were defeated near Marlborough. The survivors became captives, and those who got out of captivity surrendered and confessed they had nothing to do in the war. In August of 1676, King Philip's allies began to desert him, and over 400 had already surrendered to the colonists. King Philip, with only very few warriors left, retreated to where the war had started, and following him was Benjamin Church, who also works with Josiah Winslow. When Benjamin Church and his guiders caught up to King Philip, Church pulled out a musket and sent a musket ball through King Philip's heart. After King Philip's death, the war suddenly went downhill. In the end, over 600 colonists died, and over 3,000 Indians died. Several hundred of the captured Indians were sold as slaves in the Caribbean. The raids and attacks finally ended when Sir Edmund Andros negotiated a treaty with the northern bands of natives on April 12th, 1678. It took many years for the towns to be built up to what they were, but during the war they were destroyed very quickly. The businesses were gone and many of the people were killed. It took a very long time to rebuild the towns and to bring back businesses to support a new economy. When the colonies were under attack, they had nobody to turn to. They could only depend on each other because England did nothing to help. King Philip's War helped show the colonists that they were strong enough to defend themselves without help from their mother country, England. This war was one of the many rebellions and uprisings of Native Americans against New England colonists. The colonists had to rebuild their cities and economy by themselves. The war had also given the colonists good, trustworthy leaders like Captain Pierce, Josiah Winslow, and Captain William Turner, who emerged from the colonies and helped lead them to freedom.